even a white man that's poor, a rich white man coming to you and saying, rah, you don't need to be doing this, you know. It's like, it's easy for you to say. Like,
exactly. You're going to look at him and be thinking, listen, who are you to be telling me what and what not to do? You can come from. Because if anything, the first case, the young person can be like, listen, your life was a lot more easy compared to mine.
Mm-hmm.
You come from. So when a young person has a youth worker around that can relate to them in so many ways,
mm-hmm.
I think that's going to motivate them
mm-hmm.
in
mm-hmm.
a way to go down the right path.
Mm-hmm.
So I feel like there needs to be more male youth workers.
Definitely.
I don't think there's a lot of male youth workers.
Definitely.
I'm even not even being racist or nothing like that as well. I feel like there needs to be a lot more black role models
mm-hmm.
that these young people can look up to.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely.
So, yeah.
Wow. I feel like also people are afraid of judgment as well.
Criticism, yeah.
Criticism, yeah. Because I feel like someone might be doing something that people deem unacceptable or bad, but because someone's already labeled them, oh, you're a thug, or you're a street boy, or whatever, they're just like, well, I might as well play on the role that you've actually given me now. I might as well do those bad things.
Yeah.
But like the title of our topic today is mistakes doesn't mean that you. Wait, mistakes. Sorry, my brain. Mistakes doesn't mean the end. So there can actually be a positive change
out of it.
Out of it.
Out of the mistakes that you've made in your
life.
Yeah,
literally.
No, I agree with that as well.
I feel like back to the thing we were saying about people who have who people can relate to.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like some people feel like the mistakes they've made, oh, it's so bad, I wish I hadn't done this and that and the other. But I feel like sometimes you make a mistake, not for yourself, but for someone else. So when you made the mistake, you can go back and tell someone, look, I did this, it's not worth it.
Yeah, yeah, and don't
do,
yeah.
Yeah, don't do that. It's true. Like, my sister's even working with someone who's quite younger than her, and she's doing a lot of, well, she was doing a lot of things that she was just like, oh, listen, I've been down this road, you don't want to go down this road.
Is she a youth worker?
She works with a youth club.
Okay.
But she was just like, oh, I've been down this road, you don't want to be down this road. And the girl actually, I think it was a couple of days ago, actually called her, and she was like, you know what, thank you, because if I had done that, I've seen basically the outcome, because her friend did what she got told not to do, and now her friend is living la vida loca. So she's like, thank you, thank you so much for telling me that, because I would have messed myself up, basically.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like if I had a person like you, or if I had a person like me now, to tell me certain things back in the day, not that I would have been a lot better off, because obviously everything happens for a reason.
Of course.
But I feel like we need people that have been through things to kind of, you know,
no, definitely.
Spread love and just definitely. Tell people, you know, like, just because you've done this doesn't mean that you're a failure.
Mm-hmm.
Like, do you have anything inspirational to tell anyone that is basically listening now, that might be in this kind of knife crime, gun crime life, or maybe not even, they're not even in knife and gun crime, maybe they're selling drugs, or they're trying to do something that's kind of like fraud or something?
What I'd say is, you know, listen, at the end of the day, it's not worth it. You can come from, you're better than that. Don't do things to impress others around you. You can come from. So if your friend is maybe selling drugs or doing this or doing fraud, don't feel like you need to go down that path. Don't feel like you need to prove to someone that, how can I say, don't feel like you need to prove anything to anyone. Do you get coming from? Be yourself, be unique. Do you get coming from?
Mm-hmm.
Be yourself, be unique, and focus on yourself.
Mm.
You come from, focus on yourself. Don't watch any faces, because that's not going to get you nowhere in life. Also, life is too short to be taken.
Definitely.
Life is a joke, do you come from?
Definitely.
When you're watching the news, you know, a young person's passed away, it's not a joke.
That's the thing.
The streets are not safe anymore. So if you're the type of person where you feel like, you know what, listen, yeah, everything's good, it's not good. It's reality, like, do you come from? The streets is not safe, so if you think life's a joke, you need to sit down and actually think about your life. Have a long, long think. If you don't want your parents to be burying you or to be seeing you in prison, literally, start taking life seriously.
Wow. And have you, because obviously you're a very positive person, how have you become so positive in a world that's so negative with people your age? Like, and how do you escape people actually thinking that you're, because I even went on your Instagram, I saw a video of the carnival video.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah. How do you escape people thinking that you're that type of way? Like,
you know what, yeah? In the life we live in today, especially for like black people, us black young men, yeah, we face a lot of stereotype. So in the sense of the media portrays us as bad. The government has drawn an image, you know what, if you see a black person that has a gold tooth, he's bad automatically. Right now, as me and you're talking, you might have had a, you might have, I don't know, you might have had a stereotype towards me before. If you never spoke to me and saw me with a gold tooth, you might be thinking, oh, this guy might be a gangbanger, or I don't know. But when I start talking, you start, you know, realising, oh, this guy talks knowledge.
He's actually intelligent.
Exactly. I feel like a lot of young people are so used to being stereotyped that they don't want to do what they love in their life, do you get coming from, because of the government. So you know that day when I got stopped at Melbourne Carnival, I know I didn't do nothing wrong. So to me it's like, you know, whatever, you can search me. But I just didn't like the approach, in the sense of I didn't like the way they approached me because I was black.
Yes, yes.
And it's like they came to me and they thought I was carrying something knife. I know what I wasn't carrying nothing. And then after that, they started saying they want to search me. They searched me, didn't find nothing, and they handcuffed me. They handcuffed me. That's why on the video you can see they handcuffed me, because